Hello, hello, welcome back to the Craft Scraps. I am Lauren, and today we are going to go over what you need to get started with your Cricut. So this video is going live right after Christmas, so many of you might have just gotten a new Cricut machine for Christmas and you're like, WTF, what do I do? That was definitely me when I first got my Cricut. I was like, I don't even know where to start. So I totally know how you're feeling, and so I wanted to put together a quick video on the essentials that you need to get started with your Cricut. I'm gonna make this as short and sweet and to the point as possible, so we will just get right into it. So don't forget to like and subscribe, hit the notification bell so you always get notified when I post a new video. And with that being said, let's get into what you need to get started with your Cricut. Okay. Maybe I don't need any more coffee. Okay, so before I get into my essentials, I will quickly go over what is gonna be in your Cricut box. So first and foremost, if you have not taken your Cricut out of the box because you are super overwhelmed, first of all, I totally understand. But second of all, pause this video and go get your Cricut out of the box. I'll wait. All right, so once you have your Cricut out of the box and set up and connected to your computer and Bluetooth and all that good stuff, I wanted to go over really quickly what actually comes with the Cricut already. So what do you not have to go out and buy? So I wanted to see what exactly came in the box. So we have the Cricut Maker machine, the rotary blade and the housing for that. So I believe that's for fabric. The premium fine point blade and housing. So that is the regular blade that you will use to cut 99% of the things. Your fine point black pen, a fabric grip machine mat, a light grip machine mat, welcome book, USB cable, power adapter, free trial membership to Cricut Access, 50 free ready to make projects, and materials for a practice project. So that is already what comes with your Cricut. So you are already like pretty much set up for success with everything that comes in the box, because you have your blades, you have a pen, you have stuff to make a practice project. You're already like halfway there. And so the things that I'm going to talk about are just some extra essentials that I think that are useful for when you want to start making projects. Okay, the first essential thing that I think, okay, and so a little backstory to this. I know I said this is going to be short and sweet, and I promise it will, but when I first bought my Cricut, I bought the Cricut and went straight home from Michael's, okay? And come to find out, there was a couple other things I should have picked up at Michael's while I was there. I literally went to Michael's, and my mom, if she's watching this, she knows exactly what I'm talking about. We went to Michael's in one day, like, three times. So I'm gonna try and save you a couple trips. One of the things that is not included that I think is the most essential, like, if you were just to buy one thing, I would recommend the Essential Cricut Vinyl Tool Set, cutting set, something like that. Basically, this is everything I got in one set. So this is like a one-off pink one because I lost the blue one. But basically, this all came in a set. The most essential thing, so if you don't want to buy this entire set, the one thing I would buy out of this weeding tool is basically going to be your number one thing that you reach for when you're doing any project. If it's vinyl, HTV, cardstock, you name it, 99% of the time you're going to be using this. I know there's probably more affordable versions that aren't Cricut brand. Definitely you can check those out too. This is just the one that I've always used. I know people have used like dental picks, toothpicks, whatever. So whatever you need to use, you need some kind of sharp, pointy tool to work on your Cricut projects with. The essential tool set that I purchased came with this, a pair of tweezers that have come in handy, this little like spatula thing that maybe to like pick up the vinyl, like I don't really know what this is for, a scoring stylus. So if you got the Explore Air 2 for Christmas, which I have right over here behind me, I don't know if you could see, that was my first machine. You will need a scoring stylus. So basically this is to make scoring lines. So if you're making like a card with cardstock, it'll make that scoring like divot for you. So this, but if you have the maker, you might want to get a scoring wheel. So again, that's extra. That is like more than I'm going to talk about in this video, really. So scoring stylist, a pair of scissors. So these have lasted me, you know, 2 years or so. For some reason, I have a gazillion pairs of scissors behind me. I have no idea why. So those things. And then the one that I got also came with this paper cutter, which is kind of cool. Truthfully, I don't really use it all that much, but still a good tool if you want to make sure you get those straight, crispy lines. So my number one essential thing that you will want to get is a weeding tool. And if you want to be a little bit extra, I would get the tool set. Oh, I forgot to mention, it also comes with this little squeegee. One time I called this a scraper and someone got really mad. So, squeegee? This is to make sure everything gets smooth on your mats. All right, okay, so the next essential thing I want to talk about is the Maker comes with a light grip mat already. So that is this blue mat, and it also comes with this pink fabric mat. Obviously, I have never used this in my life, so it was nice that it was included, but I don't really use it. And the Explore Air 2 also comes with this light grip mat. You definitely don't need to go out and get more mats. This light grip mat is the tried and true, the one that I use 99.99999% of the time. But if you want to be a little bit extra, I would definitely recommend getting a variety of mats. So my mats are a little bit worse for wear. This was my very first Cricut mat ever. And so this is the green and this is the standard grip mat. This is the purple, which is really freaking disgusting. Honestly, I don't even know why I still have this, but this is the strong grip mat. And so the light grip mat, like I said, this is what I use for vinyl, for cardstock, for HTV. And I think that on the website, Cricut says that you should use like the standard grip mat, so the green mat, for like HTV or vinyl. But honestly, I think the standard for me when it's brand new is a little too sticky. So I really honestly get the most use out of the light grip mat. But if you're gonna be experimenting with different projects, I definitely recommend getting a variety pack. And the strong grip mat is really good if you have the Maker and you're wanting to do stuff with the knife blade, you're definitely gonna need a strong grip mat for those kinds of projects. Okay, so once you have your essential tools, so you have your weeding tools, your tweezers, and your mats, those are the two most essential things that I think you need to like start working on projects. So my third essential thing I'm going to talk about to get started with your Cricut is you need cutting materials. If you want to do things above and beyond what the practice project has, which I'm sure you do, or why would you be getting a Cricut? So you're going to be needing to buy, what you're going to want to invest in is vinyl, HTV, cardstock. You know, those are three of the most basic, most essential things that you can cut. Of course, there's things like chipboard and balsa wood, acetate, so you can make like reusable stencils. There's so much stuff you can cut with the Cricut. But if you're just getting started and you want to do some like super basic projects, number one, I would start off with vinyl. Number two is I would go to HTV, because then you could do like shirts and soft things and things like that. And then my third thing would be cardstock. So there's a ton of different vinyl brands. My favorite vinyl brand is the Oracle 651 for permanent and Oracle 631 for non-permanent. And there's tons of different places that you can get vinyl from. Amazon, Shop Anti-Tay, 143 Vinyl, like there's so many. So you just need to kind of research and figure out what works best for you. This video is not sponsored, but I do have an affiliate code with Anti-Tay or Shop Anti-Tay. I'll leave it in down below, but it is the Craft Scraps, all lowercase. She has tons of resources and vinyl and HTV and fun bundle packs, so you can go check her out if you want. But other than that, there's tons of places you can get vinyl. HTV is also super fun because then you can start getting into t-shirts and bags and things like that. Do you need a heat press? Absolutely not. You can totally get away with using an iron. I only just recently got the heat press that's behind me. I got it last Christmas, I think. So I used an iron. Like, if you go back and look at the first year of my YouTube videos, they all use an iron. So you could totally get away with using an iron. Of course, having a heat press, it makes it a little more consistent and easier to use than an iron, but definitely heat press is not necessary. Okay, so once you have your cutting materials, the next thing you're gonna wanna invest in, if you're doing vinyl projects, which I think vinyl is the easiest to start out with. If you are a total newbie, total beginner, I definitely would start out doing something like a glass or a mug or something like that, because those are super basic and super easy. And I have tons of videos on those, so you can check out a few that I'll link below. So my point is if you're doing vinyl projects, you're gonna need transfer tape. This is the Expressions Vinyl paper transfer tape, masking transfer tape. So it's basically like masking tape. That's really what it looks like. I have a whole video on this. I get my masking transfer tape from shopantitay.com, but you can get it from wherever you want. This is Expressions Vinyl brand, so I'm sure you can buy it directly from them, but this is where I get it from. And so basically why transfer tape is so important is because this is what you use to stick onto your vinyl or whatever you've cut out, and you're peeling it off, and then you're gonna put it on your project so it all stays together. I did not have transfer tape when I first started. I thought I was just gonna individually stick everything on, and I quickly realized that was not gonna happen. So of course there's tons of other transfer tapes. I know a lot of people use contact paper, press and seal. So those are two super duper affordable options. There's Oracle transfer tape that I used way back in the day when I first started. That was like my go-to, but this masking transfer tape is amazing and it comes in this super thick roll. Okay, so lastly, my last essential item. Let's recap. You have your machine. You have what it comes with. You have your tools. You have some more mats if you need them. You have your vinyl or your HTV or your cardstock. You have your transfer tape. So the last thing you need is you need something to put all these on. So you need blanks. Blanks are basically exactly what it sounds like. So here I just pulled a couple that I have handy. So I have some wine glasses. I have some mugs. I also have some t-shirts, some random bags, some wood rounds. Anything that you can put vinyl or HTV on is fair game in my book. If you're just getting started and you don't want to spend a fortune on, you know, buying all the fancy stuff, I highly recommend you check out your local Dollar Tree or your local 99-cent store, because that is where I get all my wine glasses from, and these are amazing glasses. And that's where I get my mugs from. And they have tons of seasonal fun stuff that you can also get there too. Definitely recommend checking out the dollar store so you don't spend a fortune on a bunch of things. So those are my top five essential things. If you are like, okay, Lauren, that's great, but I want to be extra AF and I want more stuff. Some fun extras that you can get, of course, are more pens to use in your pen feature of either of your machines that you have. You can get other fun blades. So there's the knife blade. So if you have the maker, you can get a knife blade. There's a, I think there's like, I haven't even used it, but there's like an engraving, something for engraving. Like there's tons of fun blades that you can use with your maker. If you have the Explorer Air 2, still you can get the deep cut blade. So when I first got my machine, I made Joe in mine's Halloween costumes that year, and all I had was an Explorer Air 2, and I was able to make this fun costume for both of us. So I was able to cut felt with my Cricut Explorer Air 2. I did have to bond it, but the deep cut blade worked excellent. So some other fun extras that you can get, of course, is you can get a easy press or a mini press like I have up there. I don't know if you can see it. You can get things to make stencils. So stencil film, paint, sticker paper, printable vinyl. Like seriously, the options are endless. So if you want to be a little bit extra, you can invest in some other fun things. But I think if you were to only be able to buy five things, I think the five things that I talked about, the tools, the mats, the transfer tape, the blanks, and vinyl, HTV, or cardstock, you are going to be set to at least get started with your Cricut. So to wrap up, I am just going to leave you with a couple of tips that I feel like I wish someone would have told me back in the day. Well, no, I'm sure someone did tell me back in the day, but I was stubborn, probably didn't listen. So number one is to be patient with yourself. This machine, when I first bought it, I thought I was gonna like bust out all these projects, and that was not the case. There is such a steep learning curve, and YouTube was like my best friend. If my style doesn't work for you to learn from, definitely go check out some other YouTubers. I learned from Auntie Tate. That is literally who I learned from. There's tons of other YouTubers. Corinne Blackstone is chef's kiss amazing. She has tons of tutorials. So if my style doesn't work for you, definitely go check out other YouTubers. But my point is just to be patient and to be kind to yourself, because there's a steep learning curve with this Cricut. But once you get it and once you really get into it, the options are literally endless. You're gonna start vinyling like your whole house. So my second, it's not really a tip, it's more of just like a statement, is that you are gonna mess up. I promise. You're gonna mess up, you're gonna waste material, you're gonna waste stuff, and if you can just accept that and be okay with that, you're gonna do great. I can't even tell you how much vinyl and stencil film and HGV I've wasted like money just down the drain, just because of the learning curve. So it is just the cost of learning. And so I just encourage you to please not get discouraged. And lastly, I would just advise you just to start with the basics. Like a basic wine glass, you can learn so much from just making this like simple wine glass or a mug. Maybe a mug would be a little bit better to start off with, because putting things on spherical surfaces can get like kind of complicated. So maybe start out with a mug. Maybe just start out putting vinyl on like a flat surface. Just start off with the basics. Like I tried to do, my first ever project was I was making 30 etched champagne flutes for my friend's bridal shower. It's the only reason I bought my Cricut. And let me tell you, it was rough. I mean, we made it, but it was rough. So I think that is all that I have for you guys as far as what you really need to get started with your Cricut. This is just like a quick and dirty, well, it wasn't that quick because I go on some tangents, but this is just like the top five essentials that I think that you need to get started with your Cricut, so you can get all of your stuff from Michael's or whatever craft store you go to, and you don't have to go back a gazillion times like I did. So I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you never miss a video. I got through this whole video without talking about what a dumpster fire 2020 was. Actually, it wasn't that bad. Me and Joe got married. So it wasn't that bad, but I know it was really rough for a lot of people. So I wanted to start 2021 off super strong. I think that's it. So I hope you guys have a super happy, healthy, safe 2021, and I will see you in the next one.